A third of the almost 300,000 girls and women reported missing in the U.S. in 2020 were Black. That is according to the National Crime Information Center. And yet those cases often get little attention or are all but ignored by law enforcement and national news media. Now, a four-part documentary series on HBO follows the lives of two women working to bring awareness to these cases. Amna Nawaz has the story.
The new series tells the story of Natalie and Derricka Wilson, co-founders of the Black and Missing Foundation. The sisters-in-law rally communities and help families as they search for their missing loved ones. Here now is a clip featuring Derricka Wilson.
Being a former law enforcement official, I've dealt firsthand with missing person cases. Back in 2002, I ended up getting hired on with the City of Falls Church Police Department as the first African-American female police officer in the history of the agency. My goal and aspiration initially was to work for the FBI and get into forensics. I spent 6 months in a police academy and we dedicated, an hour or two to missing person cases. I actually had a case where there was a young lady and I didn't realize that she was missing until I was able to recover her. We received a call, and I was the primary officer responding to that call of a domestic violence situation in progress. As I'm driving to the scene, I noticed two people walking really fast, and it just looked out of the ordinary. I stopped, and this young lady ran to me. It was the young lady that was the domestic violence victim. And her hair was pulled out. She had bite marks all over her body. Had to take her to the hospital to get a rape kit. She had been missing for days. She was stuck in a motel in the City of Falls Church with her abductor. She was reported missing in our neighboring jurisdiction, and her flyer never crossed my desk. And she was a young Black female. I don't want these cases to be handled sloppy because our community matters.
And Soledad O'Brien is the executive producer of Black and Missing, and she joins me now. Soledad, welcome to the NewsHour. Thank you so much for making the time. Tell us a little bit more about these two women, Natalie and Derricka Wilson. Why did you choose to center the story around them and their work?
We started this documentary process about 3 years ago because we found the work that they were doing just fascinating. You were hearing from Derricka talking about being in law enforcement and trying to use her expertise to help families who have missing loved ones who can't figure out how to break through the barrier of disinterest in a lot of cases where no one seems to actually really care enough about the person who's missing that they go the extra mile or maybe just go the basic mile to make sure that there is a missing persons flyer, that it's circulated in areas outside of just that one jurisdiction. For Natalie, who's had a background in public relations, she was interested in leveraging what she does in her day job in PR to helping families learn how to navigate the system. How do you make a media that does not seem to very often care about women of color who are missing and make them care? Sometimes that's about the information you give, the press conference you give. How do you address people on the phone? Who do you reach out to? All of that she could help. And so the two of them get together to use their skills to help communities that are, and the data shows this very clearly, communities that are very often ignored by media, by law enforcement, and sometimes by their own community when they go missing, to help them get a leg up.
This issue of the media not caring, not paying as much attention as it does to other stories, there's a phrase many of us have heard, missing white women syndrome, which the late, great Gwen Ifill is believed to have first used. And it basically means in our industry that, you know, the stories of missing white women often get a lot of attention, and the media tends to stay with those stories in a way that they do not with the stories of missing Black women or Indigenous women or Latinas. Gwen Ifill said that back in 2004. Why is this still a problem today?
Yeah, because I don't think anybody has really thought about, well, why do we not care? Is it that people in media are cold and callous and don't care about the stories? I don't believe that's true. I think there's a lot of bias involved. And missing white woman syndrome, as Gwen called it and, you know, penned it originally, I guess, also includes the wall-to-wall coverage that actually gets communities up in arms to the point where you have people flying themselves to Aruba to help look for Natalie Holloway. So it's not even just the media. It's this idea of, like, why do people as a whole just not care? In our documentary, we profile a young woman, a beautiful young woman who's Black, who goes missing. And then a couple of weeks later, Natalie Holloway goes missing. And her aunt describes what it's like to watch the attention that Natalie Holloway, I mean, I covered the Natalie Holloway case. What a horrific story for her mom to go on newscast after newscast to beg for information about her daughter. But at the same time, the aunt who's looking for her niece is saying, why does no one care about my niece? And she's reaching out to these news organizations. She's a TV producer. She has some wherewithal about how to navigate. She can't get any attention. And so I think it's about, why do we care about some people and why do we not care about others? I personally believe it's a lot of bias. I know when I've done documentaries, that focus on people of color, Black in America, Latino in America, I've been told, listen, don't make it too Black. Make sure that you don't push away the audience we really care about, which is to say the white audience. So I think there's often a sense of, our audience is this. This is a person who's appealing, attractive, interesting to me as a producer. And, and therefore, that's what should get the focus, versus thinking about what are the communities that you serve and how do you serve those communities. In our doc, we talked to a former news president who says, race is not a factor. That is just not true. That is just absolutely not true. The data does not hold that up. And so I think until newsrooms are willing to say, why do we not care? Maybe we should examine that. I don't know that you're going to get a lot of movement.
Soledad, in the law enforcement angle, is it the same issue at play there? Bias or less incentivized to follow these stories?
I think so. And also a little bit about runaways. Many, many folks told us in the process of this documentary that the police would sort of push back and say, she's probably a runaway. Maybe she went to stay with her boyfriend. The idea that someone can be in a motel with their abuser covered with bite marks and only because of a chance call is able to be saved is just too horrible to kind of wrap your head around. People should be searching. But if you call someone a runaway, suddenly there's much less of an interest in thinking that maybe you can help find them. They've run away. The folks at Black and Missing Foundation would say no one should be characterized as a runaway. If you're missing, you're missing. And that search should start immediately. Someone shouldn't be sent home to say, maybe they'll turn up. Let us know in a couple of days. We all know that the first 48 hours, obviously, are critical in gathering information about a person who might be missing.
Well, it's a fascinating series, necessary storytelling, and the four-part HBO documentary series, Black and Missing, debuts tonight on HBO and HBO Max. Executive producer Soledad O'Brien, thank you so much for joining us tonight.
My pleasure. Thank you.
And it's a story that deserves much more attention. We're so glad that it's getting it.